looks way too big. Don't worry, we're going to cut that. The 5-inch exhaust is huge. Check out Joe's aluminum welds, though. Streetcar Joe back at it again. So we got the lower hot side pipe in there. It's all wrapped up. Got the wastegate in there. Just got to tighten everything down. We redid the front side cold side pipe. See the blow-off valve on the front peeking? That's all tightened down, ready to go, Joe. Don't worry, it's cut off right there. Still in his like grudge racer phase right now. He'll get over it soon. Look how big the exhaust is. So tomorrow I'm gonna come over and heat wrap that.
Electronics?
Okay, let's go over to Joe's car.
I don't know if you guys are ready for this. Joe has been putting in work on the Fox body. Check this out.
Ooh, wait. Joe, why don't you explain what everything is for the people that don't understand?
That's a lot of wire. That's what that is.
Look at them. They're all loomed and tucked down there, and then it goes to the back of the Maven mount. Ooh, look at that Maven mount. Okay, Joe, explain what's going on here.
Yeah, lots. Holley Dominator.
Holley Dominator.
Leash street strip board.
That's that guy.
And then above the leash is a Holley injector driver.
So that's for injectors.
And then there's the boost controller solenoids. And then that is the transbrake relay and protection switch.
Woo!
Yeah, pretty much. And it's wired like from here to here is done. So now it's just finishing the car. Like I'm getting there. Yep. Like a lot of the bulkhead is done. The wires are routed. A lot of the trans wires are ready. Like it's all getting a lot closer. I just need to, you know, button up a lot of stuff. But
so you've got to wire just the engine, pretty much all the engine, sensors and everything.
Yeah, and it's like I got the rear stuff that I have the wires that I need to hook up. Like it's a lot of little stuff, but the bulk of it, I mean, this was a nightmare. I mean, there's a lot of wires. There's like four looms in here.
There's so much wiring.
There's tons of wiring. I mean, it tucked good and it looks clean. Nice. Yeah. But yeah, no, like in the end, like it's 100 and something wires going through there. Like it's a lot. There's a lot of power and ground going underneath the carpets.
It's all tucked nicely, though. It looks clean.
But yeah, and like it actually turns on. I have let me show this. So like the switch panel, it's on here. Why don't we'll just do a little?
He had this one in the Trans Am,
but here we'll do a little test real quick.
These nice little plugs you got.
So yeah, I got this nice plug.
Gosh, are you gonna start it? Cold start.
This is a cold start on
the... Look at that.
So, yeah.
Joe's got power.
So, power. Yeah, look. And the screen come screen on?
Oh, look at that.
So, no, like, it works.
Dude, they're making progress.
No, it does. That's yeah. Awesome. It works. And, like, I mean, all the switch panel. I mean,
look at that.
Yeah, the lights and the fans and pump that's and stuff. Awesome. So, I know, I mean, it's functional, and, like, all the circuits are working stuff, so, yeah, it's just...
I expect nothing less.
Yeah, I mean, I could have bought a harness that was already done, but what I did is I bought the unterminated harness. So, this is, like, the engine side harness. Like, this takes time. Yeah, oh, you can buy this with all the connectors on it, but I want to do it my way.
That's so sick.
Like, yeah, I pinned all that. Like, yeah, it takes time.
Oof. It's worth it.
It is. So, like, all the harnesses and everything I bought, it's all unterminated. So, yeah. I'm making it all. It just takes time. Like, yeah, I could have bought an off-the-shelf harness and plugged it in and thrown the Dominator up under the dash and probably would have had a running car by now. But this is what makes Joe's cars cool. Right? This is my attention to detail. I really enjoy doing this.
No, it's worth it for sure.
I like it.
So. Especially, you know, when you're going threes, right? Radio versus World, 380s.
I know, yeah, no, we're going for a
360s. Right? No, we're taking this car to freaking get ice cream. This street ice car. Cream. This is still a street car.
Street car, for sure. Like, yeah, it's going to drive. We're going to take it to Lubbock and get ice cream.
What are your planned events? I know you got some in mind.
So, yeah, gosh, I don't know what is after. There's one in the middle of April that I'm wanting to do.
That's the one at Oklahoma City, right? The 405 thing?
Yes.
There's that one.
Yeah, there's that one. So yeah, Amarillo's race and then the 405 race. And then I'm sure I'm just going to start hitting streetcar takeovers. Yep. There's quite a few of those. I think June is up in Denver, we were talking about going to.
Well, they have May is San Antonio.
May San Antonio, we're talking about going that one. So yeah, I think if it's within like an 8-hour drive, I think we're hitting streetcar takeovers.
Yeah.
We just want to cruise around and do a bunch of those. So I want to be at a bunch of those. But yeah, I'm open to all sorts of events.
Maybe a big race, right?
Yeah, no, we're going to Ducks race this fall.
Supposedly we are. I'll, I'm going.
We're going.
We talked about going there last year just to watch, but this year we're taking a car.
You can't go just to watch. You have to be there on the line for the experience. So, no, we're going to Ducks Race this year. This fall, this car will race at Ducks Race this year.
What class?
I already know. So, if they have the Carolina No Time Boosted class again, I'd be in that. Yeah. Leah was in that. John Dock was in that. That's a lot of, you know, quick cars. I'd be in that because as far as class racing is concerned, no, I don't really fit anything. I think I'd have to be in LDR.
So, yeah. With twin 102s and a Hemi.
No, LDR is like everyone's going 390s, and here's Joe going 350s because I got a billet twin 102.
That's right. See, you got the right setup.
No, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I don't even care if I fit any classes. We're going there for the experience.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, we want to go have a good time, go do a bunch of qualifying and
get
just
some
have
sick
fun.
Photos.
Yeah, just have fun. So no, definitely looking forward to that.
What other races were there? I don't know. There's a bunch. There's a bunch of local stuff.
I have a spreadsheet of planned races.
Oh, August 29th, Oklahoma City.
August 29th, Oklahoma City.
Oh, you might be doing Outlaw. You're not
March
sure.
March 28th.
That's our race.
No. March 28th. There's one Wichita Falls. I'm going to.
No, you're not. No, he's not.
No.
He's coming to Amarillo.
Okay, so 2020 races. Pulling it up.
Oh, you got the spreadsheet.
I got a spreadsheet. So we got a flashlight race March 28th. April's at 405 race. May 1st is streetcar takeover San Antonio. May 15th, streetcar takeover OKC.
Right.
July 5th is the Redemption 50K at the Motorplex prep race.
Ooh,
that'll be a good
that's
one.
That's a good one.
July 10th is streetcar takeover Denver. Definitely
one.
That'd
be sick.
September 11th, streetcar takeover Tulsa. September 18th, Battlegrounds, Mid-America Dragway in Kansas.
That's the Kansas
a
one,
race.
Yeah.
October 8th through the 11th, No Mercy.
Oh, he's already got it on the schedule.
And then October 24th, streetcar takeover Houston. November 7th, streetcar takeover OKC.
Back to OKC.
So that's not, I mean, that's like one to two events a month with June and August off.
Oh, what weekend is the T&E race? May 28th?
May 28th, but I don't know if I fit anything for that. I think that's more heavy cars.
Tank
if
stuff.
I fit a class, I'll race. Otherwise, I'll go pit with you.
Ooh.
Are you racing that race?
Yeah.
Are you going to, what's the other big Coyote race?
Modnets. I'll be there.
Yeah.
November. November.
Oh.
It's like first, second week of November. Okay. South Georgia Motorsports Park.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I won't be going.
I'll be there. Oh. I'm making some huge progress. Hopefully soon.
No, it's getting there. Like,
I don't think people realize how much time goes into
it.
How many hours you got? 200, 300 hours? I mean.
Yeah, no, it's a ton. And that's a good story. Like, I had someone ask me the other day. It's like, oh, hey, would you sell that roller? It's like, no. But it's like, but in all honesty, it's like, you know, even if I just look at the roller, take all my electronics and everything out, just the roller itself, like, I have so many hours in it, fixing all the floor
pan,
doing the seat, doing the rear, fixing the firewall, painting the front end.
Yeah,
like,
I don't think I talked about painting the front end, but there's a bunch of holes in the floorboard.
Yeah,
Joe
like,
had to weld
up. I sealed
up.
It all up. I painted the inside.
Yeah.
I painted the cage and cleaned it all up. Like, I've just done so much work painting, you know, all the pieces and fixing all this stuff. Like, I have tons of work in the roller, like, and I got the roller for a good price, but, like, yeah, it's a lot of work. But, no, I couldn't imagine adding it up, how many hours I'm into the car. You figure most nights, like, I'm out here 4 to 5 hours a night.
Oh, easily, yeah.
And, you know.
More on the weekends.
And more on the weekends.
Probably double on the weekends, easily.
So, yeah, no, you figure right now I'm probably putting 40-plus hours a week into the car.
That's a whole second job.
No, it really is. And it doesn't pay.
It actually goes the other way.
It takes money. It takes all your money.
But Joe's making some huge progress.
Huge progress.
Comment down below what you guys think of the board. I'm glad you put it there. I was against it for a little bit.
You really? I thought you were always for it.
No, there's a time when I was like, I don't know, but.
Really?
I mean, that's definitely worth it. Only because it looks a little R-wordish, but.
Yeah, no, it doesn't look a little R-word. We don't talk about that word in this garage. Because only streetcars come out.
Whatever we think is a streetcar, it's a streetcar.
Yeah, no, because it is. Like, even if you say, like, oh, yeah, Pro Mods have their electronics there. That's fine. Pro Mods can't make a 100-mile cruise.
Yeah, Joe.
All right, guys. Once again, I forgot my camera today, but we are getting very, very close to starting it. As you guys saw last night, we got the exhaust on. Intercooler pipes are back on. I got the wastegates on and plumbed. Got a few wires I got to kind of tidy up. But everything is starting to come together. So I have already put oil in it. I actually bought some 93 octane because Will from RPG, the engine builder, he says with these ID 1700s, they dump too much fuel. and it'd be dumping too much E85 into the engine for the rings to properly seat. So we bought 5 gallons of 93 octane. We're going to dump that in, and we're actually going to use that for like the initial startup and kind of drive it around the block. We probably won't drive it around the block today, but just kind of give you guys an update on what's going on. I still need to remount the battery. I'm actually going back to a stock battery for now. If you guys don't know, I had like one of those small Odyssey batteries, and it's actually in Joe's garage right now. But I want to switch batteries, but I just don't have time right now. So I went and bought like a stock battery. I'll show you. It's really heavy. I had the little Odyssey battery that probably weighed, I think it weighed like 13 pounds. And this battery definitely weighs like upwards of 35 to 40 pounds probably. So I did get a stock battery. It's just, like I said, I need a better battery. I had too many starting issues. I need a better battery, but I just don't have time right now. So with the cage being installed, I'm gonna have to make like a new battery mount. So that's kind of what I'm working on right now, is I gotta do a couple wires up top, mount the battery. Obviously the interior is still all taken apart, but what I wanna do today is at least get the harness back in, load the new tune file for the bigger injectors and everything we changed, and then at least get the car with its first few startups to build the oil pressure, and then let it idle so that I can start checking for leaks. So I'll update you guys when we start it. All right, guys, I've been super frustrated. I haven't even been filming, of course. I've been going crazy. The car would not crank over. As you guys know, we had to gut the entire interior. We took all the electrical stuff out when we did the roll cage, and putting it back together, just nothing wanted to work. So last night I spent a ton of time diagnosing, trying to figure out what was going on. Today I just finally figured it out. One of the wires that I had for the clutch pedal, which if you guys know, I have to press a button for my clutch pedal because it's a turbo 400, it's not a true manual car, that part had gone wrong. So I just wired it like together, and I just did my first four, so RPG, my first four starts, sorry, I can't talk right now. So RPG wants you to do four starts with the fuel injectors unhooked to get oil pressure going. I just plugged the injectors back in, and here goes the first start. Guys, I am so nervous right now. I know it looks like a crazy mess in here, but this is what I've been dealing with, so. Oh boy, let's see if it's gonna start. So of course, still doesn't want to start. It's just the issues I've been running into. Definitely can't hear the fuel pump still. So, which I knew this part was gonna be a problem because, well, the tank caught on fire. So I'm gonna see if I can figure out why the fuel pumps aren't turning on. All right, guys, so I found a wiring issue back there with the pumps. I just heard them turn on, so let's see. See if the Mustang wants to start this time. So there's like no fuel in the lines or anything, so I'm just trying to let it get some fuel up there. I mean, it's Friday at like 4 o'clock, and yeah, we got a full weekend of shit to get done, but there's a chance we're gonna make 2K. Oh man, that's so awesome. Guys, it is super dark out. You probably can't see anything, but the car has broken down. Oh man. So there's the car right there. And there's Ken Dog. Shout out Ken Dog for the help. So yeah, the car is it's got a blown transmission line from when the cage was welded in. It blew the transmission line. So we're gonna get a tow here, and we're in a very bad part of town, and it is super windy, so we gotta get pushing. And we're getting a tow truck. Shout out Kev for coming and hanging out, because we are in the ghetto. Tank Sting going on a tow truck. They got problems on 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 probl